a good thing Jackdaw didn't fall down there. It's a good thing Jackdaw didn't fall down there.
Eight legs is simply too many.
Not a headless skeleton in sight, but I may as well help myself to this.
Revelio.
Revelio.
Revelio. Incendio! Accio! Revelio.
I'd have thought Jackdaw would have been interested in this loot, but there's no sign of him.
Revelio.
It is. The bridge. It's almost complete. More spiders.
This can't be what the head of Richard Jackal. Revelio. Accio. Incendio. Accio. Revelio. Accio.
I'm glad Richard Jackdaw left a little something behind for me, but where could he be?
Revelio. Accio. Revelio.
The bridge, it's almost complete. More spiders. These can't be what the head of Richard Jackdaw. A victory that came none too soon.
Ready on.
imagine how these spiders have multiplied since Jackdaw came this way.
Revelio.
Perhaps the next symbol is hidden somewhere. Must be getting closer to Jackdaw's remains. And those pages. Ha. We meet again, Richard Jackdaw. Thank you for keeping these pages safe all these years. There's Jackdaw, looking dead as ever. What happened here? Might it happen again?
Revelio.
Here it is. The map that brought your doom, Jackdaw. Is there something beyond this room?
Thought to disarm you, please.
unnerving. What's happening? I've seen this before. In Gringotts and the restricted section.
Revelio.
Where am I? The room is starting to flood. How am I being protected? What sort of magic is this? I can only hope this magic protects me until I'm able to make my way out of here. What is this place?
Revelio.
Can it be?
It's you.
Has someone finally found our map chamber?
I recognize you from the Pensives. You're Professor Rackham.
I am indeed. I must confess that I am surprised to see someone so young standing before me.
I'm the same age that you and Isadora Morganarch were when you started at Hogwarts.
You've paid attention. And might I presume you share our ability?
To see traces of ancient magic? Yes, sir, I do.
As you have likely realized by now, our ability gives us a unique relationship with all forms of magic. We can access expressions of magic that few others can. Opportunities will arise that allow you to sharpen this rare talent. Do not squander them.
I won't, Professor. Thank you.
We have much to discuss, but first, a map found in a certain book led you here. Place the book on the pedestal.
I don't have the book with me, sir.
That is unfortunate. I'm afraid we must pause our conversation until you return with the book.
Very well. I'll retrieve the book right away.
Good. We shall speak again once the book is in place.
found the pages and the map. Why would I need the book?
Off on another adventure, are we? Revelio. Revelio.
I'm back at Hogwarts. I wonder when Professor Fig will be back. I did promise him I wouldn't neglect my studies while he was away. Suppose I have enough to distract myself with till he returns with the book.
Revelio. 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 Handy resource indeed, your field guide. I'm most pleased to be included.
Revelio. Revelio.
Future champion coming through.
Hello, Lucan. Is the final round of crossed wands ready?
Look who's back. Ready to redeem yourself?
I certainly am.
Brilliant. Are you dealing with a partner?
Yes, Sebastian.
Then let's get started.
We can make this a real victory.
That's the spirit.
To try again?
Yes, I'm ready now.
Very well. Good luck out there.
I'm just pleased to have done as well as I did.
And we're pleased to have such such a gracious champion. Now, to the victor goes the prize! And so it is my great honor to present you with this simple yet elegant token of supreme dueling accomplishment.
Thank you. It's been an honor.
You earned it. You are a duelist to be reckoned with. Now that we've definitively crowned the tournament winner, I suppose I should get back to my schoolwork. Wonder how my herbology plants are doing. I haven't tended them in ages.
You can't imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented flu powder.
their broom.
Everybody grab a broom, and we shall get started. Mr. Clopton, your attention, please.
Sorry, Madam Kagawa.
Everyone, please welcome a new student to our flying class.
Hello.
The goal of today is to remind all of you how to maneuver on a broomstick safely. As broom flight is, first and foremost, a means of transportation.
This, I fear, some of you have forgotten.
Diving, rolling, and loop-the-loops will not be taught or in fact tolerated in this class. We'll leave that to professional Quidditch players, like the Toyohashi Tengu. Not a fan, I take it? Now, let's see how well everyone kept up with their practice over the summer holidays. For those who need a refresher, step up to your broom. Say up firmly and clearly. Then kick your leg over and rest your weight on the seat. Up! Thank you. Now, your turn.
Up!
Up!
Up, you stupid ratty school broom!
Up! One leg over, so there's a leg on each side. None of that side saddle nonsense. A gust of wind will throw you right off. And if you hear my whistle while you're in flight, ground yourself at once. Good. Now, for your first lesson, fly through each ring in the courtyard. Do take care. The brooms are school property. I want them returned in
one
piece.
I wish I had my own broom. I think I'm getting the hang of this.
Yes. Good. And lean. Well done. Now that you're acclimatized to your broom, let's see how well you manage with a more advanced exercise, shall we? This next set of rings will take you around the grounds for more of a challenge.
What a view!
Hello! Nice day for a flight!
That wasn't too bad.
Oh, the old boathouse. Wish you could have experienced crossing the lake as the first year. Whoa! Our aquatic resident likes to make an appearance once in a while.
Brilliant.
I watched you fly through those rings. You seem to handle yourself on that dusty school broom well enough. I'd imagine you're ready for something a bit more challenging. But I'm getting ahead of myself. We haven't properly met. I'm Everett Clopton. Am I right in suspecting that a Slytherin like you might be interested in making an escape from class?
Can't say no to that. What did you have in mind?
A bit of a detour, so to speak. Me. The tour is about to begin. Follow closely now. Right now, we're flying over the Transfiguration Courtyard. Lovely as ever. Let's hope the headmaster isn't having tea by the window today. Nice to get above it all, isn't it? Ahead of the gardens. The Hufflepuff common room windows just peek out. Bit claustrophobic for my taste.
How is Everett flying so quickly?
Here's something handy to know. Lean forward for a burst of speed. Helpful if you need to escape a tricky situation.
Now that's more like it.
You sure you're not part hippogriff? There's the famous bridge. Think of all the magic holding it up. I mean, look at it. And the owlery. That's a bit of solid architecture, isn't it?
Flying dibs and a jaunt around Hogwarts. This is quite the tour, Everett.
That's Kagawa's whistle. This concludes our tour. Let's hurry back. Better hurry and hand in our brooms. Dismount here.
And where have you two been?
Oh, hello, Professor. We were trying to get a bit of extra practice in.
Hefty points will be taken from each of you for not following my instructions. Mr. Clopton, I am disappointed in you. You're in this class because you're still not showing yourself, or frankly, your broom, the proper respect.
But, Professor...
Enough! Class is finished for the day. As for you, you do well to use better judgment in the future. Chin up. That was some rather good flying.
Sorry about that business with Kagawa, but you have to admit, those views were worth it.
It was worth losing a few house points for that detour.
You seem at home on a broom. Bet if you had a fancy model, you could fly laps around Imelda. She's Kagawa's favorite. I could show her a thing or two if I had my own broom. Hate having to return the school broom after class.
Perhaps I'll have to purchase a broom then.
If you can, you should. Wish I could. I recommend visiting Albie Weeks at Spintwitch's in Hogsmeade. He's always looking to test new models. I'll keep an eye out for you in the sky.
Thank you. allowed to attend.
Couldn't agree more. Not to mention, it exposes us to their power.
And then the werewolves join the goblins in the uprising.
In the Goblin Rebellion of 1752!
And by the end of it, the Minister for Magic...
Pajamas.
There's something in there, I just...
Hogwarts is a second home to me.
Castle. Must have been quite stately in its time. any more cozy than Hogsmeade.
We have everything a young student might need when it comes to potions. Have a good look around.
Hello, Mr. Pippin. You need help with the delivery?
Yes, I do. A capable student such as yourself should have no trouble making the trip to Cambridge. It's just south of Hogwarts.
What do you need delivered?
Fatima Lawang ordered a few invisibility potions. I used to go myself, but lately Fatima has taken to turning every visit into an argument. Constantly complaining about the quality of my stock. But how can I maintain excellence when she orders so often, giving me no time to brew? If you take this rather irritating task off my hands, I'd happily allow you to claim the delivery fee from Fatima.
I'd be happy to help with the delivery.
You've no idea how grateful I am, truly. Here are the invisibility potions she requested. Hopefully she won't give you too much trouble. She's a talented potioner in her own right. I dare say I wouldn't mind having a look at her potion recipes one day.
Hogsmeade, here I come. Revelio. Merlin trial when I see one. Revelio. Revelio.
Back for more.
The beast is safer now. Shame you're so foul.
Revelio. I wonder who lives here.
Always late, that Pippin.
Revelio.
Night clothes. Unusual choice. That Pippin should have been here by now.
Revelio.
Always late, that Pippin. That Pippin should have been here by now.
What are you up?
Let's see what's up your sleeve this time, Merlin.
Always late, that Pippin. That Pippin should have been here by now.
Madame Luong, I have a delivery from J. Pippin's potions.
Ha! Sent a child to do his work for him, did he? Always cutting corners and taking the easy way out. Did he have you brew them for him as well? Doesn't matter. You could probably do it better than he can anyway.
Here are the potions you requested.
You think it's so simple? I know Pippin is always trying to cheat his customers. Cutting corners to save some galleons for himself at the expense of quality. You'll not be getting a canut out of me until you prove the potion works. Drink it.
Seems simple enough. I'll do it.
I should think so.
Night clothes.
Unusual choice.
It seems to have worked.
Well, I suppose that will do.
If the demand for potions is as high as you say, have you considered being easier to work with? Perhaps combining your recipes and skills?
Ha! Not a chance. That ne'er-do-well had his shop handed to him. The rest of us had to make our own way. I'll not give him the benefit of my hard work and gumption. If he fails on his own, so be it.
Very well. I shall let Mr. Pippin know I delivered the potions as requested.
You do that.
What do you have for sale?
What are we looking for today? A fine choice. Exactly what I would have chosen. This will do just fine. Thank you. Thank you for stopping in. I appreciate it.
Off on another adventure, are we?
Who lived here, I wonder?
Revelio.
Hello there. In the market for potions, are we?
I delivered the potions to Fatima Luang.
Very good. And did she cause you any trouble?
Nothing to worry about. I handled it.
Glad to hear it. And thank you again for your help.
It was a pleasure doing business with you, Mr. Pippin.
Likewise. Worth every bit of that delivery fee to have someone capable deal with that witch.
By the way, I found this book of potion recipes in Cambridge. Might it be useful to you?
Is this Fatima's recipe book?
You should keep it. She doesn't deserve to have it.
I appreciate what you're saying, but you have much to learn about respecting the property of others. Some things are sacred amongst potioneers. I shall return it to her immediately. Come on in. Healing potions are a speciality here, should you need any. A wise decision. Thank you. Hope to see you again. Farewell for now. What can I do for you today? It would appear that you don't have enough for that. Hope to see you again. Farewell for now.
Over here.
I wonder if any of my spells will help me through this. Accio! Incendio!
Thank you.
I could summon that platform, I'd luckily get on it. A headless skeleton in sight, but I may as well help myself to this. I thought Jackdaw would have been interested in this loot. There's no sign of him.
Revelio.
Jackdaw could solve this, so could perhaps the next symbol of hidden somewhere. Oh, behind the rock, there's the symbol. Perhaps the next symbol is hidden somewhere. the next symbol is hidden somewhere?
Revelio.
Revelio.
Untouched chest. Jackdaw wasn't very thorough in his search of this cave. Whew, it's a good thing Jackdaw didn't fall down there.
Accio!
Whew, it's a good thing Jackdaw didn't fall down there.
Incendio!
It's a good thing Jackdaw didn't fall down there.
Eight legs is simply too many.
Not a headless skeleton in sight, but I may as well help myself to this.
Revelio. 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 Incendio! Accio!